For Western countries, Churchill is someone who fought against Nazism and protected the democracy. But for India, Churchill is the person who directly caused the death of 3 million innocent people. We heard this a lot that the British had done a lot of great things for India, like they built railways, postal and whatnot. I would say we are living in this imaginative world praising the invaders and colonizers so that we are refusing to admit the cruelties that happen in this land. So here we are uncovering what kind of racist and cruel person was Winston Churchill to India. The year was 1943, the entire world was fighting with each other. India was under the British colonization and the Prime Minister of Britain was Winston Leonard Spencer Churchill. And the people of Bengal were literally dying on the streets because of hunger. Guess the number? 3 million people, that is 30 lakh people died of hunger. Wherever you go, streets, farms, rivers, everywhere full of dead bodies being eaten by dogs and vultures. So many people died that no one had any strength to perform the last rites. The price of food items was skyrocketed, particularly rice. The average cost of rice used to be 2 rupees back at that time, but in 1943 it reached 40 rupees, which is unthinkable for common people. People from villages started migrating to the towns and cities just in search of food. They were literally on the streets begging for food. These were the same people who used to do agriculture back in their villages. Now the same people on the streets begging for food, not for money, begging for food. Usually in Bengali households, the boiled rice water will be thrown out. So these people went door to door and lunchtime begging for that boiled rice water. They used to cry saying Pandama, which means mother, give us that boiled water, because they very well knew nobody had enough rice to give someone else. But what caused the shortage of food? Not just shortage, there was no food at all for the people. Where did all the food supplies go? In 1942, the Japanese captured Burma from the hands of the British. So the British thought they might invade Bengal next. So they seized and destroyed everything in Bengal that could help the Japanese to march further, including food stocks. Imagine, they seized all the food supplies in Bengal just because they feared Japanese might invade. Yashmin Khan, a historian at Oxford University, describes the denial policy that was implemented fearing the Japanese invasion. The idea was that the things would be raised to the ground, including crops, but also boats that could be used for the transportation of crops. And so that when the Japanese came, they wouldn't have resources to be able to expand their invasion. The impact of the denial policy on the famine is well evidenced. The grains from Bengal were exported to Europe to feed the soldiers of World War II. And the important thing to notice here is, they were not on shortage of food. The food supplies from Bengal were exported as a backup for the British army. Multiple ships loaded with wheat from Australia were anchoring at Calcutta at the exact same time when people were dying of hunger. But Churchill ordered the ships to continue sailing to Europe without unloading anything from the ship. The British officers in India wrote multiple letters to Churchill explaining the urgency of food supplies needed in Bengal. But Churchill refused and turned down every single request because it might affect their stockpiles in the UK, and also the ships were being used in the wars, and he thought it's not worth enough to divert the ships to India. During a government discussion about famine relief, the Secretary of State for India, Leopold Amery, stated that Churchill said any aid sent to India would be insufficient because Indians were breeding like rabbits. The Great Bengal Famine, where more than 3 million people died on the streets starving, could have been easily prevented. But one man's racism costed the lives of more than 3 million innocent people. Yes, Churchill was extremely racist and Hindu-phobic. He said about Indians, they are beastie people with beastie religion. The famine was their own fault for breeding like rabbits. See what he commented on India getting independence. Power will go into the hands of rascals, ruggers and freebooters. Not a bottle of water or loaf of bread shall escape the taxation. Only the air will be free and the blood of these hungry millions will be on the head of Atlee. In 1937, he told the Palestine Royal Commission, "I do not admit, for instance, that a great wrong has been done to the Red Indians of America or the black people of Australia. I do not admit that a wrong has been done to these people by the fact that a stronger race, a higher grade race, a more worldly wise race to put it that way, has come in and taken their place. Even his personal doctor, Lord Mohan, said, Winston thinks only of the color of their skin. Bengali actor Soumitra Chatterjee, who was 8 years old when the Bengal famine happened, stated that everyone was looking like a skeleton with just skin over their frames. He further said, people would cry pitifully asking for the liquid that come out of cooking rice because they knew nobody had any rice to give them. And anyone who has heard that cry will never forget it in their life. There are tears in my eyes now when I'm speaking about it. I can't check my emotions. Hitler is being seen as the most cruel person in the history of mankind. Then why not Winston Churchill? If Hitler is being remembered for the killing of Jews, then why Winston Churchill is not being remembered for the killing of Indians? Don't the lives of Indian people matter at all? The world is repeatedly talking about the killing of Jews. They are writing about it, making movies about it. Then why are they not talking about the innocent lives, 3 million lives lost in Bengal? It's time at least we Indians address this.